So what's up guys, my name is Clement, I'm a software engineer. So I will be your instructor in this particular RX Java 3 course. You're going to learn several modern technologies as you create this beautiful application. Now this application, by the way, is a professional application. It's already published at the Play Store. It's being used by lots of people over the world. So not only will you learn how to create such type of an application, but in the process, you're going to learn several technologies, the first of them being the RX Java. Now, as we switch through these particular tabs or as we select these particular dates, we are actually asynchronously filtering data based on the date. These items, you are storing them, of course, in the database locally using Room, and we're filtering or fetching this particular data asynchronously, okay? So you're going to learn about how to do reactive programming right here, and also the reason why this is important, why you need to do your stuff asynchronously rather than just doing them in the, of course, in the main thread. Now you're going to learn that with the RX Java. You're also going to learn about the Room, how to perform the CRUD operations. These days people no longer write the raw SQL statements. Is just not very convenient. It's also quite error prone and also quite complex. So the recommended way to work with local databases is using the Room. That is if you're using the SQLite database. Now you're also going to learn several design patterns. First, you're going to learn how to use the clean architecture to architect your Android application so that you're able to create an application that can be easily tested as well as be extended. You learn the benefits of clean architecture and how to structure your application using clean architecture. You also learn how to use the MVVM, the model view model, a design pattern that is recommended by Google. You learn its advantages and also why you need to use it in your application and how to use it. Now, the reason why we've decided to build this as a single page application is so that it makes it easy for beginners to be able to learn all these complex technologies without having to write lots of boilerplate code, okay? So rather than focusing on the user interface, we're mostly going to focus on the concepts, the skills that you're going to gain. Now, having said that, this of course is a full Android application. So by the end of this particular lesson or this particular course, you're going to be able to create a full Android application that you'll be able to upload, of course, to the Play Store. This is it, guys. These are the things that you're going to learn. We're going to use the Java programming language, and we're going to guide you step by step. Take the course. Let me see you in the course.